Now we should discuss about the traditional way transportation planning process. The traditional way transportation process is divided into the four step model. The first one is the trip generation, which is based on the production and the attraction factor. Means it is a general term used in the transportation planning process to cover the field of calculating the number of trip ends in a given area. Now the second topic is the trip distribution, which means a process in which two known steps of trips ends are connecting together without specifying the actual route and the travel mode to form a trip matrix between known origin and the destination, means the growth factor models and the gravity models. The third one is model split, which is choice of model, means trips may be made by different modes of travel. Model split is the process of separating these trips in different modes of travel, such as the walk, car, bus, railway, watership, airway, etc. Now the trip assignment. Trip assignment means which route, leading to the future capacity analyzing of roads, means the process of determining routes or routes of travel of transportation system and allocating zone-to-zone trips to these routes. Now we should discuss about the contemporary planning. Contemporary planning, which is walking cities, non-motorized transportation, sharing the cities, motorcycles, motorized planning, bus transport systems, SOL system, rapid motorizations like the, for example, of BRTS, Metropolitan, in metropolitan area, and in metro also is worked as a bus rapid transit system, means rapid transit system, example of rapid transit system, slow motorization, moderate road buildings, traffic saturated bodies, continuous motorized system, understand the motorization, restrain the private car investment in alternative, which leads to transit cities, high mobility cities, public nodes and dominates with low mobility class, private nodes dominated with the public nodes dominated, and this shows the potential transportation development for developing cities. Now we should discuss about the goals and the objectives, which are the important goals of the transportation planning. As we discuss the mobility plan is the every 5 years revise, which is important and for the city to make the policies of the planning in transportation planning. Now the important goals and objectives related to the transportation planning. The first one is the congestion and decreasing general mobility, growth in the vehicle miles, decreasing transport mode, job shifts and reducing safeties of the transportation system. Now we should discuss in more detail about the goals. For example, to provide the maximum personal mobility. This is the goal, and the main objective of this goal is to provide safe, reliable, affordable public transport and aged for the children and urban poor, to improve facilities and pedestrian and the cyclist. Now the second topic is to improve the urban environment. How the main goal is how we should improve the urban environment, and for that the objectives are to reduce air pollution due to vehicle, to reduce noise and traffic pollution, to reduce the aesthetic qualities of the urban environment, which we should enhance to minimize the disruption of community and problems. The third one is to improve economic efficiency, means the transportation system, how we increase capacity of existing facilities with the persons and good movements, to reduce the personal cost of urban travel, to reduce cost and urban movements. The next goal of the transportation is to improve traffic safety, how we should improve traffic accidents, how we should reduce the traffic accidents, how we should improve the personal safety of road users, to reduce injuries and death and to due to the traffic accidents. The next is the conserve energy resource, which to reduce the fuel consumption for urban level and to reduce electricity consumption in urban transportation. Now we should discuss the plan basic step, mobilization of human and material resources for the survey of the city. The second term is primary and secondary survey. Now the survey is divided into the different forms, like primary survey, which we should conduct it by the fields, and the secondary survey, which is the government data regarding to the transportation planning. The third is travel demand modeling. As we see in the traditional model, how the model is divided in four different stage: preparation of short-term strategies, how we should discussed with the urban transportation authorities for the short-term planning and strategies to reduce the traffic and the accident of the area. The preparation of alternative transport plans and land use plans, development of transport vision and strategy for the citizen groups and adequately involved. Now the development of project evaluation and screening framework means the provide of sound of evaluating the impacts of plan proposal and including in public involvement. Alternatively, our goal is to reach maximum good facilities related to the transportation to provide for the urban people. The main basic steps are identifying and prioritized improvements, including one more options for the infrastructure project and assessment of cost and revenues for each options and project suggested. We should improve our revenue regarding the infrastructure we should build. Recommendation of institutional setup, economic evaluation of CMP proposal, preparation for draft mobility plan. Now the stakeholder participation and citizen groups involved, plan proposal and solicit their concerns and suggestions. The last is the revision of the plan to include stakeholder construction. Now the stakeholders means the role of government. Here the main stakeholders are the government factors, which revision the existing plan every 5 years, 10 years or 20 years periods with the suitable their limitation.